Alright, so what's going on, guys? It's your guy, Ayo, and we're back with another video for today. But today we'll be covering a game I've been following for a while now. The game's called Last Epoch. It's an ARPG game, so, you know, your standard action RPG styling. This game's a little different. So as you can see, it is five classes. You have your Temple, your Sentinel, your Ranger, or your Rogue, your Old Man Mage, your Primalist, and then your Acolyte, or your Warlock style characters. And as you can see, each class has its own three subset of classes. Most classes have all three unlocked, I believe, because this game still is in beta. The Acolyte and Rogue, which has been added since I last played, and it's been a while since I touched the game. You know, they're all three of their masteries aren't unlocked. So let's go inside and see what the game is like. I have played it a little bit before this recording, so I can get a set of it. So as his character kind of looks like me, minus he doesn't have glasses. Hop in here. Those Kangs. If you know, you know. So it has your typical standing stuff. So standard and hardcore mode, you die, that's it. Solo, meaning solo. So whatever you find on this character is for this character only. Your stash tabs are not shared, as far as I can see. So if you do want to be able to share your character stuff, I would say play standard and not solo. If you only want to be able to find stuff for that character specifically, or you don't think you're playing anything else, then go ahead and play solo. I like playing solo. It gives it a different feel. And then Masochist doesn't really do anything else. It just makes it difficult. No additional rewards, just more difficult. So, create this character.
I am the Sentinel. I spent my youth working the forges under Solaran, helping to arm the holy armies of Raya. When I came of age, I was conscripted into the Golden Army and sent to war, wielding the very weapons I helped create. What I found on the battlefield was chaos and the slaughter of innocents. I deserted Raya's army, refusing to be a part of this destruction. Now I travel the land of Eterra, warning its people of Raya's wrath.
Story of this specific character. Pretty sure every character has its own backstory.
This land is peaceful. I must warn them before Raya scorches this place to ash.
So, standard bar, left click to move, right click does your basic attack. And then, because I have a gaming mouse, I map my skills out 1-4, and then I use key.
Oh, yeah. Touch me, Webby.
Run around, kill things, follow the story. Like I said, this game is still in beta, so I'll probably a lot more videos out that cover way more in-depth stuff, but I wanted to cover it because it is a gaming style and platform that I do heavily enjoy. From your simplest one, Diablo 3, to your more difficult, i.e. your POEs and stuff like that. So, as you level up, you get skills. And then skill system, which I think is the coolest part about this game personally. So Your skills are here. You get these just from being your class. So as you level up, you'll get more of these. These are also just basic abilities you'll get from your class. And then these are based off your specialization. So Void Knight has its own set of five skills that you'll unlock based off of how you put your points in. Same thing for Forge Guard. And then same thing for Paladin. And then within each one of these skills is an even deeper skill tree, which allows you to change and modify the skill even more. So if I was playing Shield Throw, let's see, 20 mana cost as of right now on a 2-second cooldown. Taking this just off base will take 4 mana off, bringing it down to 16, and then probably more mana reduction further on. I would say probably cutting it down by at least 50%, if not more. I can make it a fire, a pure fire ability, which actually probably seems cool. And then I can tag it along with something like Shield Bash if I chose to continue on with this character. I'm not sure yet. You know, taking this stuff, which also, if I use this ability, it's also fire base, giving synergy. And then the same thing, these Void Knights has its own abilities that do void damage. There's fire within these here. And then, yeah. So you pretty much run around.
I cannot do that.
This game is, which I'll show you after I get out of this zone. So next area, stash, nothing in it.
Greetings, traveler. Care to see my wares?
Sells things I could use if I had some money.
Carry on then. Careful on the road.
Let's see. So, this game has something like I would call a mana tax. So, let's say I can find enough enemies.
Yeah.
So, I cast the ability and use it now, which I'm using it for a second. And I can continue to use it even when I'm in negative mana, but at a certain point, it'll no longer go. So up to a specific amount of the negative mana, and then it's like, alright. So, and then once I get back to positive mana, I can go again. So again, on top of the skill tree system, you also get these passive points here. So, putting points into this tree here will unlock these abilities at the bottom. And also will strengthen my character to an extent. And then whenever I get to the point of unlocking these, so let's say I was going Forge Guard, so weapons master for instance, strength per point, throwing attack damage. So if I was doing Shield Throw, put points there until I got Shield Throw, and then continue to work down that tree until I then hit, you know, manifest armor, and then continue on and so forth till the skills I got are needed. Each skill has its own mastery ability, so This one has Forging Strike, yada yada yada, so forth and so on. So we continue on forward, pushing through this part of the story. So that's the basics so far. So like I said, I have been playing somewhat, so I do have a primalist who I named Louis. Should be a couple more E's on there, but that didn't let me. So my primalist is a two-handed character as of right now, using the upheaval skill, and then the summon wolf. So right now I'm working on pathing to getting an additional wolf, so it'll give me two wolf companions. I have my wolf built to, when it kills, to do the howl, which will give me a damage boost. And then my upheaval, I'm pretty sure I'm going to go with some type of cold conversion. So I max this out. I'll start pathing towards these. And then I think I will take these for the defensive purposes. And then maybe these, I'm not sure how many points you get, but we're still, you know, figuring it out. My wolf, same thing. I'll take anything in relation to cold, because that's what I'm scaling at the moment. And then, you know, at 20, I will probably take Warcry, I think is what I looked at, because it has more, you know, cold-related things. And then I can get this Maelstrom here on top of it for more cold stuff. And then I'll probably grab that ability and scale it for even more cold based damage. But that's all I have for now. Probably more update videos as I make changes or continue to level up the character. It's been I, boy Ayo. Remember to like this video, comment what you think about the game, or if you are playing it, let me know what character you're building. It's been your boy Ayo, and I'm out. Peace.